Oh no, you can mess around with it all you want. I'm saying if you hit that, it's gonna turns into a Van Halen concert. So this is like an overdrive. This adds a little bit more. But that's
good morning. That's exciting. That's our new store. So we're going to go over a couple of pieces that we'll need to effectively worship today. And we're going to have a sprinkling. And during our sprinkling, we're going to sing this. And if you can put up Gather at the Water, it's a second song. Just put up the refrain for that. So it goes like this. We will gather at the water, gather at the water. We will gather at the water and receive new life. Let's try that. We will gather at the water, gather at the water. We will gather at the water and receive new life. I think I started it high, but let's one more time. We will gather at the water, gather at the water. We will gather at the water and receive new life. So we'll do that during the sprinkling, and by the end of Easter, you'll be experts at that song. And for our last song, we're just going to go over the refrain. It's very easy. It's called Sweet Redeemer. It goes like this. Sweet Redeemer, I surrender all I am to you. And then we just repeat that. Sweet Redeemer, I surrender all I am to you. Let's try that. Sweet Redeemer, I surrender all I am to you. And again we sing. Sweet Redeemer, I surrender. Good. If you want to add harmony, that's okay. Just joking. And so as we begin our celebration today, we'll be singing Come to the River. So let the church rise.
Come Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
We begin this second Sunday, this Divine Mercy Sunday, in celebration of God's love and mercy, in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Got a lot of water in front of Deacon Joe and me. You know what that means. My friends, in the healing waters of baptism, we are free from the powers of sin and death. May the waters we have here draw us ever closer to Christ in the resurrection. Lord our God, in your mercy, be present to your people's prayers, and for us who recall the wondrous work of our creation and still greater work of our redemption, graciously bless this water. For you created water to make the fields fruitful and to refresh and cleanse our bodies. You also made water the instrument of your mercy. For through water, you freed your people from slavery and quenched their thirst in the desert. Through water, the prophets proclaimed the new covenant you were to enter upon in the human race. And last of all, through water, which Christ made holy in the Jordan, you have renewed our corrupted nature in the bath of regeneration. Therefore, may this water be for us a memorial of the baptism we have received, and grant that we may share in the gladness of our sisters and brothers who at Easter have received their baptism through Christ, our risen Lord.
Amen.
We will gather at the water. Gather at the water, we will gather at the water and receive new life. We will gather. Of creation, love breathed upon the waters, beyond the ocean to this farm. Now in this beginning, in this goodness flowing, receive the welcome of our God. We will gather at the water. Still he makes a way for us. Just as he stood in the Jordan, he is standing with you. Receive the mercy of our God. We will gather at the water.
You know, I'm not sure why everybody closes their eyes when we come around. Have you noticed that? May Almighty God cleanse us of our sins, and through the celebration of this Eucharist, make us worthy to share at the table of his kingdom.
Amen. Amen.
We praise you, we bless you, we are calling you.
Let us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal Feast kindle the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let's be seated now. And as we prepare for the Word of God, I want to invite Kim to come forward. And boys and girls, if you want to get a little break and kind of do a little talk more about Easter, come on up. Wow. You all look so wonderful. Did you have a good Easter? Yeah? So we're all happy that Jesus loves us, right? Okay. Are you all, oh, wow, you're going to help out today, Henry? Oh, a new helper. Thank you for your help on that. Well, we're going to send you forth, and you go have a good time, and we will see you in a little while.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was of one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them, bring the proceeds of the sale, and put them at the feet of the apostles, and they were distributed to each according to need. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thank you.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God, and everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by him. In this way, we know that we love the children of God when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we keep his commandments. And his commandments are not burdensome, for whoever is begotten by God conquers the world. And the victory that conquers the world is our faith. Who indeed is the victor over the world, but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came through water and blood, Jesus Christ, not by water alone, but by water and blood. The Spirit is the one that testifies, and the Spirit is truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you.
On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now, a week later, the disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, all through the doors were locked. He stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed. Now, Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book. But these are written that you might come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through his belief you may have life in his name. Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good spring morning to you. Bonnie, the sun is out. It's going to start getting warmer soon. God bless us. During the week, earlier in the week, I saw my assignment was to preach today, and I looked at the gospel. And usually I read it a few times during the week to get familiar with it. And reading this gospel, you see, I think Thomas generally gets a bad rap. Poor Thomas. As I look through the gospel of John, from which we hear today's gospel reading, I see Thomas as a very bold character. When Jesus tells his disciples earlier in this gospel that he wants to go to Jerusalem because Lazarus was sick, the apostles protested. The Holy Land is a dangerous place. They say, Jesus in Jerusalem, they were just trying to stone you. Jesus says, very persistent, I am going to Jerusalem. And at this, Thomas, the one we hear about doubting today, who speaks up and says, let us also go with him and die. Today, the gospel starts. We see the disciples huddled in this dark room, scared that they may be caught like Jesus and persecuted. But Thomas wasn't with them, which made me ask myself, where was he? Usually they were all together, but where was Thomas? And missing. Missing in action, I guess you would call it. Why isn't Thomas hiding the rest with the rest of the other disciples? Now, unfortunately, Thomas was matched by a gift of trust. When this group of disciples whom Jesus knew had just been holding and shaking in their boots, Jesus tells them, they tell him, they have seen the Lord. And Thomas doubts their story because they just told him they saw the Lord. I would have asked myself for more proof also than just hearsay. So, don't just fill our ears with stories, but hands, feet, and a side. Yeah, that could do it for me. If I saw the feet, the hands, and the side, that convinced me. There's Jesus. We know the end of the story, okay? Jesus appears to the second time to them, and offers Thomas the opportunity to examine the wounds. As you read deeper into the gospel, Thomas does not go over and examine and touch. Jesus gives him the opportunity to do that, but he doesn't do it. Many people infer that by only what we see, it presents Thomas with the opportunity. And Thomas, in response, makes one of the most profound statements in all of Scripture. He says, Jesus, my Lord and my God. Not just Lord, Master, Ruler, but Jesus, you are my God. It's an incredible time. And in a statement of faith that he made. knowing myself, and it reminded me of this when I was felt that God might be calling me to serve the people in his name as a deacon. I quite rationally doubted the fact that it would be me and that I could do such a thing. In fact, I tried to squelch the idea and run away from the possibilities, which in essence made me like the apostles huddled in that upper room today, locked and trapped in my own thoughts and my own concerns. Fortunately, our God is a persistent God. Remember, he wanted, "I am going to Jerusalem." Very persistent. God is persistent. Who came through my locked doors in my own mind and invited me to exchange my doubts for deep faith and trust that God will do things through me. I know my own skills, such as proclaiming the word of God and preaching it. As I was first invited many years ago by God to be a deacon, I went and inquired about it. My wife, Peg, came with me. I was accepted into the diaconate program. But you know, I kept saying to myself, this is not for you. But God persisted. He put people in my lives, a couple nuns and a couple priests who kept saying to me, "Joe, if that's going on, you have a calling. God wants you to serve. He wants you to give his word, read the gospel, assisted ministry. He wants you to do these things." So the invitation is there. And through it, all the works of charity that I can do to help God and service to others, I know that will work through me. God never gave up on me, as he hasn't given up on any of you. I got out of the program for a year because I still wasn't sure. I still had my doubts. My room was still locked. But as I said, God was very persistent in me, and he insisted on having me serve. So I went on retreat and came back and said, I said to Peg, "I think I'm ready." She said, "Will they take you back into the program?" I said, "I don't know. I have to ask." So a year and a half later, a new class was going to start. So I was contacted by a priest who went to school with me as a child and said, "Joe, think about it. You have a calling. God wants you." As of that moment, I went through the classes, and here I am in front of you, talking to you about my God, our God, God who loves us, the God who's persistent in saying, "I want you to be my child. Accept me into your life. Be that person I invented you to be when you were born." That's my story. Right. You know, when you make a statement, you sneeze, someone says, "You know, that's the truth." That's the truth. A child yelling out like that, that's the truth. So I say to you, good morning, God bless you, and happy Easter.
Without any doubt, let us stand together and profess our faith, for I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty,
creator of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only God, the Son of God, born of the Father, before all ages,
God from God,
light from light, true God from true God,
God.
I must say, you did a wonderful, wonderful profession of faith. The Nicene Creed, which was developed in the year 325, liturgically, Jim and I had talked about it was going to be the Apostles' Creed that we were. So what you were seeing on the screen was actually what we intended for everybody to do, the Apostles' Creed. Thomas has a lot of doubts in us today. We'll try to get it, so I take the responsibility for that. So we will try to do the Apostles' Creed next week, okay? Little lesson there. Now, drawn together as a community of believers, let us place our prayers and petitions before the risen Lord.
Strengthen the church to be one of mind and one of heart in the risen Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Fortify the faith and community support of all people initiated into the church at Easter. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May your promise of peace known to all people suffering from tragedies of war. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Draw close to your tender care in all people who grieve or suffer at the foot of the cross. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring mercy and forgiveness to all those in need of these gifts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Give new life to those who have died, especially Rita and Tom White, and grant them joy in your everlasting kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Compassionate God, your resurrected Son appeared to the disciples with his wounds from the cross of full display. Hear our prayers and embrace our wounds with your healing power so that we might too experience the joy of the resurrection. We offer this prayer through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Let's be seated. We'll prepare the altar, present our gifts, and welcome back our children.
And so we do prepare our table and our gifts, and we join our voices in singing the words to Prayer of St. Francis.
Make me a channel of your being. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel. Spare in life.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable by God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good, the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblation of your people and those you have brought to new birth, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord. Any boys and girls, you want to come on up and sit around the altar, come on up now. I can see a few parents giving you the shove. Great. Make yourselves at home, okay? The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sin of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, has restored our life. Therefore, we're come with paschal joy. Every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who loved the human race and who always walks with us on our journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love, and when as once for the disciples, so now for us, He opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking of this mystery, Almighty God, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son, and confirm in us the bond of communion. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Dennis, our Bishop, with all the bishops, priests, deacons, and all of your people, grant that all the faithful of the Catholic Church may look upon the signs of the times by the light of faith, and may constantly devote themselves to the service of the gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all that, sharing their grief and pain, their joy and their hopes, we may be faithfully bringing them the good news of salvation and go forward with them along with the way of your kingdom. Remember our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection, give them the fullness of life. And grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with all the apostles, martyrs, and all the saints. We shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Boys and girls, we're going to pray in a prayer that probably you learned at home, and that's the one that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, "Peace I give you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the risen Christ be with you always.
With your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Nice witness. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who have gathered at the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Just as a little primer, if you will, to communion, it will be offered under both species, which means you're welcome to receive from the cup after you receive from the plate. We'll be having the people with the body of Christ with the plates at the usual stations that you're customary with, but we also will have cup ministers. We're going to start with two and see how the response is, and if there's a need at some point, we'll increase it to the way it was pre-pandemic, but after you receive, coming up the aisle here or in the far aisle, there will be a cup minister in each of the side aisles if you would like to receive from the cup. Any questions?
comes along. Hold on to love.
For those who will be taking the Eucharist, please come forward. We heard about Thomas and his doubts, and Deacon Joe says he got a bum rap. But how about all of us who have our doubts? There should be no doubt what is in your hands right now. It is Jesus Christ, the Lord. And you were called to leave this community with that same faith that Thomas developed to go forth and bring him to the world. We send you with our blessings and our peace. May the peace of Jesus Christ be with you, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you, Al. Just want to thank everyone for a wonderful celebration. We got started. It looks like very shortly we're going to have to expand to the pre-pandemic cup ministers. So we'll be working all those details out. And it's just great that so many of you are receiving from the cup. We do apologize. What happens was, you know, the people in the back, unfortunately, we ran out of the blood of Christ. So have a talk with him today. And we'll make sure that we have plenty of the Eucharistic wine, the blood of Christ, next week. So thank you for that. Thank you to our music ministry. Thank you to our technology. Thank you to Bill Singer, who created that wonderful piece on what we now have to offer, some merch from Catholic Community of the Holy Spirit. It'd be great to see some of those logos as I'm walking into the shop right to go grocery shopping. And they make great things. So we appreciate that. Thank you both for serving. Thank you to our ministers of hospitality, our greeters. And I want to thank Deacon Joe for preaching a homily today. The part that I really enjoyed, Joe, was when you gave witness to your own doubts. And I think that's how we connect when we preach, is to make sure that we are giving witness to Jesus Christ. So all of us with our doubts will go forth knowing that we have been touched by Christ. And we send you with our blessings. I think someplace there's a couple of announcements from our youth ministry office, and let me just go through it real quickly. The Gen Now will be hosting a planning meeting from 6:30 to 8 p.m. in the Youth Center, located across the parking lot where the old parish office was. Middle and high school teens are welcome for planning, message, and prayer. That's at 6:30 tonight. And then the On Your Own New York City bus trip on June 1st, there needs to be a clarification because it's not a trip for teens, but for adults who want to support Gen Now. The young people are welcome to participate accompanied by adults over 18. I hope that clarifies that. Have a great day, celebrate Easter, and we'll see you soon. Let's stand and close our prayer. Thank you. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal Sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. Bow down for the blessing.
May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and adoption, give you the gladness by his blessing.
Amen.
Amen.
May he whose redeeming work have already been risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and always.
Amen.
Thank you.
Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
That's weird.
Okay.
And so we are sent forth, sweet Redeemer.
Jesus and the mercy giver of grace, I have come to sing glory, to lay my heart before you in this place. Sweet Redeemer, I surrender all I am to you. Found me in the darkness, you were my light. When I fell down, you forgave me, lifted me up, and held me in your side. Sweet Redeemer, I surrender all I am to you.
Definitely.
Nice to meet you.
Hi. Thank you. Oh, thank you.